Welcome to Slash-A-Thon. Welcome back to MegaNerd Squad. Today we are doing the ranking of the entire Halloween franchise. It's going to be tough. We have our list written down. They are very similar. There's only three slots that differ, but we're going to figure that out.
We got down the rankings. And today it's time to finally decide which one's the best and which one's the worst.
Cue music. Okay, here we go. In last place, there are 11 movies, by the way. And yes, obviously we're including the third one, Season of the Witch.
And that's the worst one.
And that's where we're putting it, right there at 11. Right, because although it's a good cult classic, different movie, I love me some Michael Myers, and he is not in this movie.
At all. One thing I do want to say.
The only thing that he said is they actually played the movie Halloween within this movie.
I like the song in this movie.
I hate the song.
I love that song. It's like, Happy Halloween, Halloween, Halloween.
If anything, I like the masks that they're making. But other than that, I like Tom Atkins also. Other than that, eh.
This movie was just not.
It's interesting. And I know a lot of people love it. It's not my favorite. Not your favorite. Right?
Yep.
It's at slot number 11.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, if this was his own original, like, solo movie, it could have worked.
Exactly, yeah. I mean, it's fine, yeah. But when you're throwing it in with all these other Michael Myers movies, yeah, it doesn't hold a candle to this.
Did your brain fry or something?
So what's the worst steaming pile of dog shit within this franchise next to part three that doesn't even have Michael in it? One that has Michael in it, but in a way, it's not really Michael.
It's not Michael. It's
because he's actually just a hobo in this movie. Yeah. And that is Rob Zombie's dog shit H2.
Duh.
I'm sorry, it is. It's fucking crap. The beginning of this movie is actually really, really good. I will say that. That's the only thing that's keeping this movie alive at all.
It's only got 10 seconds.
No, it's like the first like 20 minutes. Like, but she wakes up and it's all a dream.
Yeah.
So that was like, okay, well that's irrelevant then. I hate watching dreams in movies. Unless it's a Nightmare on Elm Street.
Yeah, then you want to see all the dreams.
Flashbacks are okay, all that, but I feel like a dream sequence is just kind of, like, why am I watching this? But, yeah, I don't like that one. That's the only thing I like about it is the intro. And it's one of the better intros, actually.
Rob Zombie actually tried to make his own Halloween, but it obviously didn't work at all. He tried to give Michael
purpose. I kind of like his first remake. I just don't like the beginning of that one. So it's the opposite for me. Rob Zombie's Halloween, I like that one, but I really hate the first, like, 40 minutes or whatever when he gives a reason why Michael is the way he is. Michael doesn't have a reason the way he is. And he changed that. You can't change that. The thing with H2, that's another thing. You can't change who Michael Myers is. He made him out to be an actual person. He talks in this movie. You see his face, like, almost the whole time in this movie. He does not have the same outfit, obviously. He reminds me of a really big, tall, strong hobo. He's got a big, giant beard. Because zombie loves big, giant beards. That's fine. But that's his Michael Myers. It's not my Michael Myers. So at number 10, we got H2.
At number 9, Halloween 5.
Halloween 5, The Revenge of Michael Myers. This is not a total loss. I like the ending. I like a sequence in the middle when Loomis has his kind of one-on-one to Michael, even though Michael's not even really there. He's in the distance in the woods or whatever. It's right before the end of the movie. I like the ending, how they kind of go down together. Michael is getting shot with tranquilizers and hit with a piece of wood by Loomis, and he falls over on top of him. Yeah, I'm sorry that happened to you, man. But it was actually pretty solid. But then after that, they just took him and put him in a jail cell. It was just weird. I can't really get on board with that too much.
Yeah, but always in Michael movies, Michael Myers movies, the kills are good. And then the fifth one as well, the Revenge of Michael Myers. It was pretty good.
I hate his mask in this one too. Like, if there's any of them that I think is probably the worst mask, it is the fifth one. Is the worst mask. It's... Fourth one's kind of a terrible mask too, but it's actually a good movie, so that's why that one's a lot higher. So yeah, The Revenge of Michael Myers. Also, I hate the cops in that movie. They got these two goofy-ass cops, and they keep playing this dumb-ass music every time
you
see them.
Oh my god, that's so annoying.
I hate that part. So, I mean, that's why at slot number 8 above that, that's why Resurrection is better than that one. Part 8 is actually 8th place on our list, which is, I guess, fitting.
I did like where they headed in Resurrection, kind of, a little bit. I mean, just the whole new aspect.
I like the idea of it. I think it's a good script and everything. And I think a lot of people hate his mask in that one. I kind of like his mask in that one. Halloween Resurrection at number 8. You got Busta Rhymes in that one. The thing about that is it's funny and it's bad at the same time. It's just... He's like a Taekwondo type of guy in that movie, and he ends up whooping Michael's ass towards the end of the movie using his Taekwondo moves, which just doesn't make sense. You can't do that to Michael. That's another rule you just broke, and that's why you're at number 8.
At number 7, we do have Rob Zombie's remake of Halloween.
Yeah.
They try to do his own thing. I hate the first part of this movie so much, I want to throw it away just for the first part of
this
movie.
I don't want to see Michael as a kid unless it's for 1 second, and I don't want him to talk
ever. They should make a cut of this movie where it's just... the last hour. So, yeah, that would be way better. But I hate just, that's why I really don't watch Rob Zombie as much, because the first part is pretty bad.
Yeah, it's just, it's really like a lot of his other movies, where he just, it's kind of like...
disgusting.
Just kind of grungy and dirty and grimy, and just a lot of foul language and perversion a lot of the time. You know, that's kind of his thing.
That's why
he's an artist, he's got really good music. I like his music a lot better than his movies. But I'd say the one movie that I actually do kind of like is his Halloween. I think he did a pretty good job. I like the mask in that one. I hate it in the second one because it's like ripped off. That whole piece right there is like ripped off and you can see his face. Like, I hate H2. I kind of like the first one. I just don't like the beginning. I don't like him giving a reason why Michael is the way he is. Michael has no reason the way he is. That's what's freaky about it. So anyway... other than that, we move on to the middle slot at number 6. I think it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. Number 6 is Jamie Lee Curtis returns to reprise her role as Laurie Strode. Yeah, 20 years after the original.
I like
Halloween H2O. Halloween H20.
I love the setting of this one. Where there,
I do too.
She's with her daughter at her school.
Her daughter?
Her son.
Yeah, her son.
At the school. They're at the school, and Michael just finds a way there, and she has to protect herself and other people. I do enjoy this one.
Like, it sets in California. She's like the principal of a, like, it's like a private high school.
Yeah,
it's a private school, and she's like the principal of it. And she's in the kind of like the witness protection program, where she's got a different name. That way, if Michael ever does come after her, he can't find her. But ultimately, he does. I like this movie. I think it was handled with care. I like Steve Miner as a director. I think he did good with this. I don't know, it's an enjoyable movie, and it really did have a good ending. Had this been the last movie, I think it would have been pretty solid.
Mm-hmm.
The thing that I don't like about it is Michael's mask, for the most part, in this movie. Because they used a lot of CGI, mm-hmm. you know, to try to almost change it almost every time you've seen it, and it was just kind of not that great. But it's still not the worst mask, by any means. The worst mask, for me, goes to 5. H2 kind of sucks, and so does 4's. Which also brings us to our next spot at number 5 is Halloween 4, The Return of Michael Myers.
This one wasn't bad either. It was just, these top 5 are just hard to
The top
to really
5
pick.
Are...
they're all good.
They're, like, I can watch these without complaining.
Yeah.
Other than Michael's mask in part 4.
Just if we had to rank them, we have to rank them. Like,
the thing is, his mask is terrible in that, but honestly, like, I think I have it right here. They knew the mask sucked in that. And so for the marketing for it, they even used the mask from the first movie. It's like, had they put the regular mask on the poster, oh, that would have been bad. I don't think anybody would have went and seen that. Well, they would, because Michael's back. But yeah. Anyway, the mask kind of sucks, but the story is really, really solid. And I love the feel and look of this movie. I love that Dr. Loomis returns. You think he died at the end of Halloween 2 with that big explosion, that poetic ending. Monster and creator going down together. He's alive. And he's just got, some burns and stuff on him. You know, he wears gloves to cover up his burn-up hands. Then Loomis slams his hand down and he's like, look, you're not going to have a repeat of what happened like 10 years ago.
Yeah.
So he's like, okay, look. So the cop, who I love in this movie, the sheriff, actually agrees to help him, and he does a good job. And I love that the sheriff does not die in this movie. In this movie, other than Loomis, I'd say he's my favorite character. And I like Jamie a lot. She does a really good job. Get to meet Laurie Strode's daughter. So she's adopted by another family. He ends up trying to go after his niece.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what is the whole story of the fourth and fifth movies. I like the ending, the way they kill Michael in it, with all the police and everybody shooting him, blown up with guns, and then he falls down in the thing,
really cool.
And they drop the dynamite.
Yeah.
But then, yeah, I love that ending, but then after that, they do the thing where Jamie kills her stepmother and is going to be like the new Michael Myers. But then they kind of changed that when they went to the fifth movie.
That's a little weird.
Yeah. So, I don't really like that ending, but I liked Michael's ending in that movie. You get the whole mob going after Michael Myers because he says how Michael Myers is back and he creates a lynch mob and they all go after him. Michael takes all them down, no problem anyway.
Yeah.
But I like that because he went to the police station and killed all the police within the police station. So that's what Loomis says to the sheriff after. He's like, damn it, you just created a lynch mob. And he's like, you haven't got a police force. Okay, so our dilemma now. Our top four. These four are definitely easily my favorites. And like, it's hard to put them in a category. You know, like to put one on top of the other because I love them all so much. But we're going to put Halloween 2 at the spot of number 4. That's a very tough decision.
Because the ending of that one is amazing, where Dr. Loomis dies with Michael, but Michael doesn't die.
It's debatably better than... It's debatably the best ending. And I think that it is actually the best ending.
Yeah.
But, on the other side of that, it's not the best movie. You do get Michael Myers' mask again. It's the only movie where they use the actual same mask. It's just they used a different actor, so it fit on his face differently. So
he has a
slightly different look, but he still looks awesome. So I love this Michael Myers as well, and I am sad that he's not in the top three.
And another thing I do like about 2 is that it's a direct sequel to the first one. And
yes!
This is 4 years later, which I actually really love. I love when movies take place
right.
But this one took place right after.
I don't know, I feel bad having it in fourth place.
Right the second after. He doesn't even agree with himself.
I don't. I am a Gemini.
That's why this is number 4.
I got 2 different sets of lists. It depends on what mood I'm in.
At number 3, we do have number 6. Paul Rudd's in that movie, and I can say it's one of the best things about this movie.
A lot of people hate on this movie. You either love it or you hate it.
Paul Rudd is amazing in this movie.
Next to the original, this is the one that scared me growing up as a kid. I knew of Halloween 2. I didn't really like that one too much growing up. Now it's easily one of my favorites. Part 6, the best mask since the original, which is the first two. I do think it is the best mask. I do like that one a lot, your 2018 look, Michael.
Yeah, I love this mask.
But number 6, I love this movie. A lot of people hate on it. They call it the Black Sheep. It went through a lot of bad things during production when everybody wanted things going differently, and then also, this is the last movie that Loomis is in. Donald Pleasance passed away shortly after filming this movie, so they went back and reshot some things. And I'm glad they did, because the theatrical cut is 10 times better than the producer's cut, in my opinion.
Yeah, and they changed the endings up too, and we've seen both endings. It's just weird, because one ending, Paul Rudd was with Michael in the little lab or whatever.
Yeah. There's 2 different endings to it. The theatrical cut is the one I knew about. They only released the producer's cut only like a year or two ago.
Oh, okay.
In the last 2 years, I'm pretty sure, is when it was finally released. And I do not like that one as much at all. It ends very weird. They focus more on the cult of Thorn, and I love the idea of this cult being surrounding Michael and wanting to channel his energy to do whatever tasks or whatever, but I understand the obsession. It's almost like Dr. Sartain's obsession with Michael. and wanting to keep him alive and study him, and he mustn't be harmed. That's essentially what this cult is. This one, it just scares the hell out of me. I love the intro to this movie. One of my favorite intros, introducing Stephen Paul Rudd in this movie. And he plays a serious role. I love Paul Rudd. He does a great job in this movie. Other than Loomis, he's my favorite character in part 6. The Curse of Michael Myers.
I love things. I love how he saves the two at the end. Mm-hmm. And I just like how he has been watching the whole time and just sees Michael. It's kind of fun to see him.
And yeah. So yeah, at number 5, we have 4. At number 4, we have 2. And at number 3, we have part 6, The Curse of Michael Myers. So that leaves us with the first 2 slots. Number 2, the runner-up.
The sequel from 2018, only a year ago, and it's at our number 2 spot.
Yep.
This...
They did a really good job with this
movie. You guys saw a review yesterday, but... We know this movie is just everything that a sequel should be, and it only came out a year ago, which is so hard to do now.
Yes, 2018, you saw the review. We love this movie. It does disregard all the other ones, but this is a really good sequel in a different, timeline.
At our number one spot. Oh, you guys know what's our number one spot. It just can't be beat. You can't beat
the number one.
You can't beat this original.
The rule of the original applies to this franchise for sure.
Yeah.
The originality.
There's something perfect about the original, and it just scared a lot of people in that time and paved the way for slasher.
It scares people now. Well, me.
Yeah.
Because I go back to that childhood memory of watching it, and I'm like, yeah, this is terrifying. A stalker in a white mask that just goes around killing people for no reason at all. He doesn't talk. You cannot see his eyes. Black, lifeless eyes. Yeah, this one does it for me every time. 1978 is always number one on my list. It's my go-to. It's my favorite horror movie of all time. It's also my favorite horror franchise of all time, the Halloween movies.
Yeah.
I think this is the best franchise. I think out of all the franchises that we've done, this is my favorite franchise. I mean, also because... It's my favorite movie, my favorite slasher. It has the best movies within it. Like, I have 5 here.
My favorite
that I'm obsessed with.
I love Chucky. Like, it's just awesome to see her. She played this role perfectly. The kills you get.
You get the Trinity.
The whole stocking of Michael.
The Trinity is John Carpenter, Jamie Lee Curtis, and Donald Pleasance.
Everything is in this movie.
They did this on a tiny budget at the time, respectably for a feature film, a small budget. A crew that everybody was super young on. I think John was like the oldest one. He was like 27. They had to take out like an extra $10,000 in order to pay Donald Pleasance. I think he was only there for like a week, and I think he got paid $20,000. And it was the best decision they could have ever made, because he essentially is the one who actually really brought it to life. His acting, his exposition, talking about Michael, that's what really created Michael. I'm not giving him all the credit, but I would say that is the one thing that really pushed it over the edge. The character of Dr. Loomis portrayed the portrayal of Dr. Loomis by Donald Pleasance. Greatest acting I've probably ever seen. I love Nick Castle as the Shape, Jamie Lee Curtis as the Scream Queen. John Carpenter, you're my favorite horror director of all time.
Yeah.
Wes Craven, honorable mention, he's my number 2.
That was our ranking of the Halloween franchise, and that will end Slash-A-Thon.
Yes, it's the end of Slash-A-Thon. So let me run down the list for you. 1 through 11, we got the original 1978 John Carpenter's Halloween. Right after that, we have the 2018 Halloween, David Gordon Green. And then we move on to part 6, which a lot of people probably disagree. I just love this one so much. It's very dear to me. It's the last one Donald Pleasance is in. The Curse of Michael Myers at number 3. Number 4, we have the second one, which I feel bad it's not in the top 3, but that's where we have it. Halloween 2. Then we have part 4, The Return of Michael Myers. Then we have Halloween H20, 20 years after the original. Rob Zombie's Halloween. Halloween Resurrection. Part 5, The Revenge of Michael Myers, the worst mask you'll ever see. The biggest, worst Michael Myers you'll ever see in Rob Zombie's H2.
Yep.
And then you won't even see Michael Myers in Season of the Witch.
Yep.
So it falls at the bottom.
We guys do hope you did enjoy Slash-A-Thon this month. We hope you guys did love the intro and the outro for all our videos throughout this month. And we just really, guys, hope you enjoyed what you saw here. And we're going to have plenty of more special things coming up. So just stay tuned for that. We want to thank you guys, all of you guys, for whoever watched all of our Slash-A-Thon videos, that saw everything, all of those videos.
Yes. If you guys didn't watch them, you can go back and check them out.
I have a playlist for Slash-A-Thon, so just go click that playlist.
If you like slashers and you want to hear our opinions on all those movies, go ahead and check them out.
Thank you so much for watching the video as well. And make sure you guys hit the like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you know when we upload brand new videos. Thank you guys so much for watching our Slash-A-Thon. And this is the end of Slash-A-Thon. We'll be back next year. And we're going to start getting back into our normal schedule. Anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for watching. MegaNerd Squad.
Out!
Blank, pale, emotionless face. And the blackest eye.
We're out here recording videos on Halloween, baby. Slash-A-Thon is over. We thank you guys so much for watching. Love you guys. MegaNerd Squad out.
Love you guys.